I'm Jaideep Deshpande. Today we are going to understand how to analyze a stepped rod system in ANSYS Mechanical APD. A rod has length 500 mm. The first section of the rod has area of cross section of 250 mm square. The second section has area of cross section of 150 mm square. We are applying the load of 500 kN at the rightmost end and we are fixing the leftmost end. The material of the rod is steel, which has elastic modulus of 200 GPa. Since we are considering the unit system in mm newton second, the elastic modulus is 200 into 10 to the power 3 newton per mm square. Now let's discretize the system. We'll be creating three nodes with two elements. The element number 1 will be joining of node number 1 and 2, and the element number 2 will be joining of node number 2 and 3. We'll be applying the force on node number 3 and we'll be restricting the motion at node number 1. This forms a standard 1D problem. So now let's go to the ANSYS and understand how to solve this problem. First we go to preprocessor. We'll select the element type as beam. Now the trick is that if we select the three node type element, in this case we have to analyze the system with two different sections and the total number of nodes available are only three. So if we select three node system, the entire beam will have same cross section, and that is not the case that we are looking for. So we'll select two node system and divide the entire beam in two different elements. So now click on OK and close. This beam 188 does not require any real constants. So we'll go to material properties, go to material models, go to structural, linear, elastic. Since steel is isotropic, click on isotropic and have the Young's modulus over here. Now the Poisson's ratio is 0.3, so add the value and click on OK. Now the material part is done. So now we'll create two different sections. Go to beam, common sections. Now for section number 1, let's have the name say first section. Then we'll have circular profile. Radius can be computed using the area given. So for area of 250 mm square, the radius comes out to be say it is 8.9206. NNT are the divisions along the circumference and radius. So we'll have say 10 divisions in this case. Click on apply. Now we'll create second section. We'll name it say second. So we'll select the profile. For this the area is 150 mm square. So 150 divided by pi by 4 root of that by 2, so that gives me 6.91 mm as the radius. We'll again have 10 divisions and click on apply. So we are done with the section part. Now we will move to the modeling part. We'll create nodes first. So we'll go to create nodes in active coordinate system. Our first node will actually be the origin. So with respect to the origin, our second node is at 300 mm distance. So for node number 2, the distance would be 300 mm. Click on apply. And for our third node, the distance is 500 mm. So our nodes are done. You can see over here. So before creating the elements, let's understand how to assign different sections. For that, you have to go to element attributes. Here under the section number tab, it gives you the all available sections that are there. So we'll first create section with first cross-sectional area. All elements created now will have the same section. So we'll select 1 and 2 and press OK. The section after 2, that is between 2 and 3, has the properties of section number 2. So we'll have section number 2 over here. Go to auto numbered again and through nodes 2 and 3 will create the element. Now to cross check whether we have rightly selected the cross sections, go to plot controls, go to style, go to size and shape. Here you have to turn this display of element on and click on apply. Everything has disappeared. Now go to plot and select elements. So here you can see our step is there. Our step is created. So now we are ready to apply the boundary conditions. For that, go to solution, define loads, apply. In structural, first we'll have the displacement of the leftmost node restricted. For that, select all degrees of freedom and put the value 0. Click on OK. So here you can see the supports. Now we'll apply the load. go to force on nodes, select the rightmost node and put the value 500 kilonewton 500E03 and click on apply. Now our system over here is ready. Let's solve it. Go to solve, current load system, load step, and our solution is done. To interpret the results, we have two options. One, we can have some data like some list, or we can have some plots. So let's first see how it looks like. Go to plot results, select contour plot, go to nodal solution. Under degrees of freedom solution, since this is a 1D problem, we'll restrict ourselves to X component of displacement. Click on OK. So here you can see the gradation of displacement all along the length, but you cannot exactly make out at say node number 3 what is exactly the value of displacement from this. For that, we'll go to list results, we'll go to nodal solution, we'll select exactly the same X component of displacement and click on OK. So the values of displacement are 0 mm, 3 mm and 6.3353 mm. So how to check whether these values are correct? So let's see the solution. The solution for this problem is U2 is 3 mm and U3 is 6.337 mm. U1 will obviously be 0 since it is completely fixed. So for our second node, R value is 3.001, this is 3, and R value is 6.3353 for third node, and here the value is 6.337. So the values almost tally. Therefore our solution is correct, our system was correctly analyzed, and therefore I'll conclude this video. Thanks for watching. If you have not followed my channel, please go to YouTube and follow my channel. Thanks a lot.